Chris Menard here. Let's see if Microsoft Copilot Chat can give us some details about S&P 500 annual returns. And we're going to look back at a variety of years. So I've already pulled up Copilot Chat. I do have this new version that's rolling out. Just to be clear, it is June 1st, 2025 today. And everything that was on the left has been moved over to the right. And we've got some new features in here if you have an M365 license. But I'm using this as if you don't have an M365 license and I'm on web. The chat box has also been moved to the middle. So let me just paste this in here. So create a table showing the S&P 500 returns for the past 10 years, 15, 20, 25, and 30. And I did tell it to make it a table. So let me send this off. And it comes back with a great table, and I didn't even ask for it, but it shows annualized returns in one column, and the far right column is showing the inflation-adjusted returns. Now, it's also telling me the source it got it from, the Motley Fool. That works for me. So if you're wondering about the last 25 years, if you notice, it's showing the years 2000 to 2024, and the returns in the middle column were 7%. If you didn't know this, the reason for that is the dot-com bubble that happened in the year 2000. The S&P went down over 10%, 2001 down over 13%, and then 2002 down over 22 or 23%. I can't remember the exact number, but it was three straight years of declines. That rarely happens, by the way. And then also in 2008, we had the housing bubble. So I'm going to ask Copilot this question. Why was the last 25 years? I asked Copilot, why was the last 25 years only 7%? I hope it comes back and tells me something about the dot-com. And sure enough, it broke this out for me. This is one reason I just love Copilot Chat right there. And it got into the housing crisis also, which happened in 2007, 2008. There you go, right there. Very good, though. Let's see if it'll give me a chart finally. Yes, show me the chart. It's actually prompting me for that. I didn't even have to type that in there. There is a great chart right there. So that is Microsoft Copilot Chat. If you have a business account or an enterprise account at your office, everyone should have Copilot Chat for free. The web version, just to be clear, you have to get a M365 license and pay for it to get this work item over here. Thank you for your time. Hope you enjoyed this video. Take care.